Hello everyone, welcome for this session. Am I clearly visible and audible to you people? Someone from the audience, please confirm. Give me a thumbs up if I am clearly visible and audible to you people. Just give me a second. If I can see, I can clearly visible, audible, so I can start the session. Okay, I hope I am clearly visible and audible to you now. Give me a thumbs up, I can see the chat or not. I have to see. Someone from the audience, please give me a thumbs up in the chat box. Okay. So I welcome you all for this session. I am Dr. Priyanka Sachdevi, a NEET PG educator on an academy. And today I am here to take my series ahead. I have launched a series that is image-based question discussion. Now in this era of this image-based questions, in every competitive exam, whether it is NEET, FMG, INICT, or whether it is going to be next, whatever competitive exam is going to happen, most of the questions are going to be image-based questions. So a thorough concept of all the images should be there to all of you. So that's why I have launched this series, image-based question, in which daily we take one system and we discuss all the images related to that system. So yesterday we have discussed cardiovascular system and we have discussed many important images in cardiovascular system. Today my system is renal system, the most important system for image-based discussion. We will discuss many images from this question. Image-based MCQs will be there. So I will launch questions one by one and expect you to participate in the answers. So this is the first question in front of you. You can see this is the first question. The image is in front of you. Take the clues from the question. Look at the image. Decode what is given in the image and then give the correct answer to me. So I will help you in solving it. So there is a 3-year-old child. So it is a pediatric. It is a pediatric age we are talking about. 3-year-old child is having a renal mass. So what is the most common renal tumor? In the last lecture only I have told you this thing. So what is the most common renal mass in a pediatric age? Biopsy is given in this picture. So in the biopsy, what you can see? Just decode the biopsy. What is given in the biopsy? What you are seeing here in the biopsy? In the biopsy, you can see these are the tumor cells. Let me mark tumor cells for you. You can see these are small tumor cells. The tumor cells are looking like lymphocytes. They are arranged in nest. This is a 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 nest. So in the nest, you are seeing the tumor cells. The tumor cells, now this, the pattern is nesting. Let me decode this image. The pattern is nesting, number one. It is in the form of multiple nest. Tumor cells are small, round and blue. So I am not having an option to zoom it out. The tumor cells are small, they are round and they are dark blue with circular dark blue nucleus. And you can see here abortive tubules. These are the abortive tubules. So based on this scenario and a child is there with a renal mass and this is the biopsy of renal mass, what will be your answer? What will be your answer? Yes, anyone? Anyone from the audience? So just a second. Yes, Rajat, you are right. The correct answer here is D. So the correct answer here is Wilms tumor. So this is a typical diagram of a Wilms tumor. You can see here. So these are the tumors present in kidney. Wilms tumor is among one of them. It is known as nephroblastoma. And it is typically seen in pediatric population. Here the tumor cells are arising from primitive renal epithelial cells. It is the most common malignancy in young children. Most common age is 1 to 6 years. Most common gene to get mutated is WT1, which is present on chromosome number 11. Please learn the chromosome also. Grossly, the whole tumor, the whole kidney is replaced by tumor only. I cannot see separately normal kidney. I cannot see separately tumor. Tumor is involving whole kidney, so normal kidney is pushed at the periphery. It is present at the periphery only. Normal kidney is present and it is a triphasic tumor. What do you mean by triphasic? There are three things in the tumor. One is the, in the diagram also you can see, one is the blast. See these small round blue cells, these are the blast. These are the nest of the blast. These abortive tubules are epithelial components. So there is blastemal component, there is epithelial component and see the background. Prior to see the background, the fibrous background. So that is known as mesenchymal component. So there are three components. It is always triphasic, typical triphasic. The picture is also triphasic. Blastemal component, epithelial component and mesenchymal component. So it is a typical diagram of Wilms tumor. So the correct answer here is Wilms tumor. Very correct. This is the next question in front of you. Please read the question first. Then tell me what is the correct answer. Five options are there in front of you. I'm sorry. Read the question. Now it is related to this question only. You can see again a 5-year-old child is there. So again we are talking about pediatric population. Having complaining of pain in his abdominal region. Dull pain in the abdominal since last 2 months. So it is a subacute condition. A 5-year male is there. 5-year-old child is there. So we are talking about a child who is having dull pain in the abdominal region since past 2 months. So some subacute condition is there. Physical examination reveals a palpable mass in the posterior abdomen. So there is a mass in the abdomen. A CT scan is done. It is showing mass is arising from the kidney. So one of the kidney, left kidney, is showing the mass. Nephrectomy is done. And the specimen is shown to you. This is the specimen of nephrectomy. This is the specimen of nephrectomy. Nephrectomy means removal of the kidney. So this is the kidney specimen of that child. So what will be your diagnosis? Your options are in front of you. Is it a Wilms tumor? Is it a urothelial carcinoma? Is it a renal cell carcinoma? Is it an angiomyolipoma AML? Or is it a rhabdomyosarcoma? What is the answer here from the audience? Anyone interested in telling? What is the correct answer here? And why? What is the correct answer? My first question and why? Why is my second question? Yes, anyone? Anyone from the audience? Yes, what is the correct answer here? Yes, the correct answer here is, of course, it is A. It is Wilms tumor. It is Wilms tumor. So why it is Wilms tumor? Because there are multiple things there. It is a child. Most common tumor, and the tumor is arising from the kidney. So most common tumor in kidney in child, or most common abdominal mass in a child, it is the Wilms tumor. Ye ek reason hai. Dusra diagram is showing typically this is the normal kidney. This is the normal kidney. This is the normal kidney. And here is the tumor you can see. This is all tumor. This is all tumor. So tumor is replacing the entire kidney, and tumor is lobated, variegated and lobated in appearance. So this is typical. This is typical gross. Just a second. This is typical gross of Wilms tumor. So the correct answer here is Wilms tumor. So this I have already explained to you. Correct answer here is Wilms tumor. I am coming to the next question here. You can see the next question is in front of you along with the image. Please read the question. Take the clues as usual. So try to take the clues from the question. So 81 year old female is there. There is an 81 year old female. So age is 81. That is an old female with chronic renal failure. So you should know the causes of chronic renal failure. Patient is having chronic renal failure. What is the most common cause of chronic renal failure at this age? You should know it. The glomeruli is showing a nodular areas of hyalinization. So can you see the diagram in the mesangium? There is typically nodular areas of hyalinization. Can you see? This is a glomeruli. Let me explain the image to you. This is a glomeruli. You can see a nodule here. You can see a nodule here. You can see a nodule. So the pink color material inside the nodule, that is hyalinization, hyaline material. So hyaline deposition in nodular pattern inside the glomerulus, inside the mesangium, that is typical presentation of which of the following disease? So the options are, is it diabetic glomerulonephritis? Is it membranous glomerulonephritis? Is it MCD, minimal change disease? Is it MPGN, membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis? Or is it APGN, acute proliferative glomerulonephritis? So what is it? I'm giving you a chance. What is it? Anyone wants to say what is it? Yes. What is the correct answer here? So it is a very easy question. You can see typical nodules of hyaline deposition in the mesangium inside the glomeruli. An old patient with chronic renal failure. What will be your answer? Yes. Anyone? What will be your answer? Yes, the correct answer here is, very correct, the correct answer here is, it is diabetes. Now, diabetes at this age is very common, and diabetes is the most common cause of chronic renal failure at this age. So, it is the most common cause of chronic renal failure be failure, or sabse badi baat, image is typically of diabetes. So, you should know a minimal change occurs in pediatric population. So, ye yahan se hata do. Membranous or membranoproliferative usually occurs in young population, can occur in old also, but it is not the scenario. उसमें आपको membranous और membranoproliferative दोनों में आपको membrane, basement membrane thickening मिलेगी. So there is thickening of the basement membrane, it is not nodular arrangement. So ये इसका pattern नहीं है. और APGN में you will typically found neutrophils inside the glomerulus. So it is not the image of this also. In this image I can't find neutrophils, so it is not APGN. I can't find thickening of the basement membrane, so it is not MPGN and MGN. And it is not a pediatric, it is a old age, so it is not MCD. So the rule out करके भी correct answer here is diabetic glomerulonephritis. So the correct answer here is diabetic glomerulonephritis. I would like to tell you something here about diabetic glomerulonephritis. There are two diagrams for diabetic glomerulonephritis. Glomerulosclerosis. It occurs in two forms, diffuse and nodular. So you can see this diagram. This is a diagram for diffuse. Can you see a glomerulus? Let me explain. Can you see a glomerulus here? Of course you can see. In this glomerulus, hyaline is deposited at three places. Number one, hyaline is deposited here in the basement membrane. See this pink material. In the basement membrane over the capillaries. Can you see? These are the circular capillaries. Over the circular capillaries in the form of cap. Aisa lag raha hai, is capillary ne cap pehna hua hai. इस कैपिलरी ने कैप पहना है, इस कैपिलरी ने कैप. सो ओवर द बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ कैप, इट इज नोन एज फिब्रिन कैप. इट इज नोन एज फिब्रिन कैप. नंबर वन, इट इज डिपॉजिटेड इन द सेंटर इन द मेसेंजियम. कैन यू सी पिंक कलर मटेरियल इन द सेंटर? सो डिफ्यूज मेसेंजियल मैट्रिक्स डिपोजिशन, हाईलाइन. सब जगह है हाईलाइनिंग, लेकिन कहां कहां डिपॉजिट हो रहा है. एंड थर्ड, इन द बोमेंस कैप्सूल. इन द बोमेंस कैप्सूल यू कैन सी इन द पैराइटल एपिथेलिया हियर एंड हियर ऑल्सो. ये जो पूरा बोमेंस कैप्सूल है ना आपका, इसके अंदर इट इज डिपॉजिटेड. इट इज नोन एज कैप्सुलर ड्रॉप. सो सी थ्री थिंग्स आर देयर. देयर आर थ्री थिंग्स. कैन यू सी दीज थ्री थिंग्स? नंबर वन, इट इज इन कैप्सुलर, इन द वुमेन्स कैप्सूल, कैप्सुलर ड्रॉप. नंबर टू, इन द बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन ऑफ द कैपिलरी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द कैप्स, इट इज नोन एज फिब्रिन कैप. एंड नंबर थ्री, इन द मेसेंजियम, इट इज नोन एज मेसेंजियल मैट्रिक्स डिपोजिशन. सो तीन जगह, इट इज नॉट नोड्यूलर, इट इज डिफ्यूज, हर जगह हो रहा है, थोड़ा यहाँ, थोड़ा यहाँ, थोड़ा यहाँ. सो दिस इज नोन एज डिफ्यूज ग्लोमेरुलोनेफ्राइटिस, इन विच हाईलाइन, हर जगह डिपॉजिट सेम चीज हो रही है. द पिंक कलर ए सेल्यूलर हाईलाइन इज डिपॉजिटेड एट मल्टीपल प्लेसेस. This is the diagram, and this is the second diagram, which is known as nodular glomerulonephritis. Here also hyaline deposit hoga, lekin it is not diffuse, har jagah nahi hoga. It is in the form of nodules. Can you see this nodule, this nodule, this nodule, this nodule? So it is not in basement membrane, it is not in capsule, it is not, it is in mesangium. In mesangium bhi it is not diffuse, it is nodular. So this is known as nodular glomerulonephritis. So you see this diagram, it is nodule, it is nodule, it is nodule. Nodular wala jo hai, it is known as KW kidney. The full form of KW, you know, it is Kimmelstein-Wilson kidney, nodular wala. And this is pathogmatic or more specific. So in dono mein se, more common diffuse hai, lekin more specific nodular hai. More common is diffuse wala, lekin more specific or pathogmatic is nodular wala. So you know the differences between them. Along with it, vascular lesions mein hyaline deposition in the blood vessel dono mein milega. Hyaline arteriosclerosis aapko dono type mein milega. और ट्यूबुलर चेंजेस में यू विल फाइंड पीसीटी. कैन यू सी दिस ट्यूब्यूल? दिस इज अ पीसीटी, दिस इज अ पीसीटी. दोनों में आपको लिपॉइड मटेरियल डिपॉजिट मिलेगा. दिस इज नोन एज, दिस लिपॉइड मटेरियल डिपॉजिशन इज नोन एज इन द पीसीटी अरमानी इब्सटन लिजन. सो सी द समरी. दिस इज द समरी. थ्री टाइप ऑफ लिजन आर देयर. Two in the glomerulus, that is diffuse and nodular. Nodular is known as KW. Diffuse more common, nodular more specific or pathogmatic. Vascular lesion mein hyaline arteriosclerosis, tubular lesion mein Armani-Ipsen lesion. So is diagram mein aapko question mein kya diya hai? Glomerulus diya hai. Glomerulus do tarah ke hote hain. In your diagram, which one is given? You can see a nodule here, you can see a nodule here, you can see a nodule. So it is nodular type diabetic glomerulosclerosis. Aur question mein bhi aapko description mein nodular areas of hyalinization it is described. So give me a thumbs up if you find this question useful. And many new questions. इस बार question आपको मैंने nodular पे दिया. Maybe image change करके next time question diffuse पे आ जाए with the same history. थोड़ा सा description change करेंगे. So instead of nodular area, there are diffuse areas of hyalinization and I will change the image. So answer will be same. Give me a thumbs up if you got it. You should know other images also of these four to rule out the other option. Give me a thumbs up if you got it. Everyone, give me a thumbs up. So should I proceed ahead? Okay. I would like to proceed ahead. This is the next question in front of you. Who would like to solve it? Please solve it. Please interact and solve it. Anyone among the audience? I will read it for you. A 65-year-old male is there. So age is important. It is 65. Again, I am saying. Having worsening renal failure from the past 10 years. So it is a chronic condition. 10 saal se renal failure hai. It is not acute suddenly ho raha hai. It is chronic since 10 years. He is having worsening renal failure. Now he requires dialysis. Now he is on dialysis. Itna chronic bilateral renal failure ho gaya hai. More than 90% of both kidneys are destroyed. It is not functional. And that's why the patient is on hemodialysis. We have done a sonography. Abdominal USG is done. Both the kidneys are enlarged. They are big in size. And it is both now. So something systemic is there. So it is both hai. It is not local cause. It may be some systemic cause. Because both kidneys are enlarged. Based on this gross appearance is given in the image, which condition the patient is having. So patient is having SLE or patient is having RCC, renal cell carcinoma. So see the image first. What you can see in the image, is it a urinary tract obstruction wali kidney hai? Is it a dominant polycystic kidney hai? Or is it a chronic glomerulonephritis wali kidney hai? So what is your answer? My first question to you, what is your answer? And my second question to you, why? First, let me see who is telling me the answer. A, B, C, D, five options are in front of you. See the image na. It is very easy. Image dekhke hi aapko andaza lag jayega kya option correct hai. So looking at the image, you tell me what is the correct answer here. Who will tell me? Yes, What is the correct answer here? I'm asking to you. From the audience. Anyone from the audience? I can see your chat, I guess. What is the correct answer here? Yes? So it is not chronic glomerulonephritis. Let me rule out. It is not chronic glomerulonephritic kidney because in that the kidneys shrink in size. Typically chronic hallmark ye hai. Kidney shrink in size and show scars. So here in the question, kidneys are enlarged and I can't see scars there. I can't see. What I can see? I can see multiple cysts. Some are small size cysts, some are large size cysts ranging from 0.5 to 2 centimeters cyst. Multiple cysts I can see. Multiple cysts. This one. So it is multicystic kidney. Is it a SLE? No, SLE means glomerulonephritis. So this is not the picture of SLE. Is it RCC? RCC mein kisi focal ek jagah tumor hoga. Aur dono kidney mein ek saath RCC kyun hoga? RCC hoga to either right kidney or left kidney mein hoga. Both kidneys are showing same scenario. So it is not RCC. It is not SLE. It is not chronic glomerulonephritis. Urinary obstruction mein hydronephrosis hoga. So again hydronephrosis unilateral hona chahiye, both side nahi. Aur hydronephrosis mein we will find single cyst. Single big cyst, not multiple small cyst. So single big cyst milega. So it is not urinary tract obstruction ki wajah se hydronephrosis bhi nahi hai. So the correct answer among these is autosomal dominant PKD. It is known as PKD polycystic kidney disease. It is a typical presentation of PKD. Have you got it? So I will tell you something about PKD ki baat nikli hai. To PKD pura bataungi main. In PKD is of two types. Ek bachchon mein hota hai, ek badon mein hota hai. So autosomal recessive PKD, it occurs in children, and autosomal dominant PKD, it occurs in adults. So ye bachcho mein hota hai, recessive wala, it is in children, aur dominant wala hota hai adults mein. It is in infancy and it is in adults, usually 3 to 5. So hamara patient jo hai, he is 65 year old age. So isme autosomal dominant wala hoga, autosomal recessive wala nahi hoga. It is AD PKD, it is not AR PKD. ARPKD, and what happens in both of them, whether it is AD or ARPKD, the complete kidney converts into cyst. So here you can see in ADPKD, this is adult wala, the multiple, all the kidneys destroyed and kidney get converted into multiple cyst. And here in infantile wala, recessive wala, ARPKD, you can see here the cysts are elongated in the form of cylindrical. Here the cysts are like balloons, spherical, circular. Here cysts are elongated like cylinders. In both of them, the entire kidney, the pelvic ischial system is gone and it is converted into cyst. That's why both of them are known as PKD, polycystic kidney disease. Multiple cysts are there. Shape of the cyst is different, but one is autosomal dominant condition, one is autosomal recessive, and both are due to genetic mutation. So tell me the name of the gene. Tell me the name of the gene which is mutated in both of them. If I talk about adults, ADPKD, there are two genes. ADPKD1 gene and ADPKD2 gene. ADPKD1 gene is present on chromosome 16, which is mutated in 85% of the patient. And ADPKD2 gene is present on chromosome number 4. The name of the gene is PKD1 and PKD2 genes, which is present on chromosome number 16 and chromosome number 4, lung chromosomes also. And here only one gene is present in ARPKD, bachchon wala jo hai. Isme only one gene, PKHD1 gene, that is the name of the gene, it is present on chromosome number 6. So chromosome number 16, 4 or 6, teeno yaad karna hai. Yahan pe do gene hai, jo mutate hote hai, 85% mein 1 wala, 15% mein 2 wala. Yahan pe ek hi gene hai jo mutate hota hai. Learn the number of the gene. Us gene ke mutation ki wajah se, the entire kidney got converted into multiple cyst. So here in our diagram, this is our diagram in this scenario. Jo hamare question mein hai, this is the diagram, and age is also matching. So these are the differences you should know between them. Here it is symmetrical bilateral enlargement of both kidney. So hamare question mein it is, and the cysts are bade macrocyst. Here in this recessive wala, it is microcyst and elongated in the form of cylindrical. In ADPKD, हमारे question में नहीं दिया, लेकिन other organs में भी cyst हो सकते हैं, usually liver में hepatic cyst और brain में intracranial aneurysm भी associated हो सकता है. So question can be much better अगर ये दो चीजें और add कर दें. तो liver में भी cyst है, brain में भी cyst है, along with kidney में cyst. तो diagnosis और confirm हो जाएगा, या maybe ये आपको अगले question की history में मिले. Done. So that is the thing. So there are two types of PKD. I have explained both of you, and both of them are bilateral, both of them are genetic. The gene is different, age is different. You can see the gene is different. You know, yahan pe do genes hai, PKD1 gene, which is present on chromosome 16, and PKD2 gene, present on chromosome number 4. Here, PHKD gene, only one gene, it is present on chromosome number 6. 6, 16 and 4. So these are mutated. That's why kidney got converted into cyst. The size and shape of cyst is different, and both are genetic, and both will result in renal failure. The patient will be on dialysis. Infantile within 1 year present kar jayega. Ye adult wala, it will present after third decade. So hai bachpan se mutation, lekin present 30 years ke baad karega. So patient will be on dialysis afterwards in old age. Done. Yes. So Diksha is right. So you were right, Diksha. So okay. Let me move to the next question. So this is the next question in front of you. Please solve it. This is the next question in front of you. I will show you this image separately also. See the image. Image achche se dekh lo. Now read the question. Fir se image dikhati hu. Just read the question. So 54-year-old woman is there. Presented to general physician, GP. Complaining a dull, vague left side back pain. Left side pe dull back pain hai. On the left side, not in the center. So it is not vertebra. Vertebra hota to central pain hota. Back pain hai, but on the left side. Dull pain hai. And investigation reveals hematuria. She is having blood and urine. So blood and urine along with a palpable mass on the left side. So general physician have examined, have done the palpation. On the left side, there is a something palpable mass in her abdomen. The age of the lady is 54. We have done a chest radiograph. A chest radiograph is done. It reveals multiple opacity throughout. We have done a chest x-ray. Chest radiograph means chest x-ray kiya aapne. है ना चेस्ट आपको पाल्पेबल मास एब्डोमेन में मिला है और आपने चेस्ट एक्सरे किया चेस्ट एक्सरे पे मल्टीपल ओपेसिटी इन बोथ द लंग्स तो बोथ द लंग्स में मल्टीपल ओपेसिटी भी है और एब्डोमेन में लेफ्ट साइड पे एक मास भी है एब्डोमेन में वी डोंट नो एब्डोमेन में वो मास है वो क्या है लेकिन लंग में मल्टीपल लिजन्स है ये पक्का है वन ऑफ दीज लंग मास इज बायोप्सी तो आपने बायोप्सी लंग मास का किया है एब्डोमिनल मास का नहीं सो लेट मी ड्रॉ अ पेशेंट फॉर यू ओके So this is the patient, this is the lady, this is the lady, lady presented to you with a left side dull pain. So this is the left side dull pain, you have palpated, there is a mass on the left side, you have done a chest x-ray, in the chest x-ray you can see multiple opacities in the lung. So you have done biopsy from the lung and you don't know the two conditions are related or unrelated, we really don't know. There are two things till now in the question jo mere dimag mein hai. Done. One of the lung mass is biopsy and biopsy is shown to you. So this is the biopsy of lung mass. This is the biopsy of lung mass. Now see the cell, see the image of the cell, what you can find in the image. Now read the option. So which one of the following is correct in the diagnosis? Which one of the following is correct? The clinical and histological features are of TB. Ye TB hai kya usko dono jagah? Aur biopsy shows a carcinoma with clear cell. Can you see this biopsy is of clear cell? Most probably metastatic renal cell carcinoma in the lung. तो मे बी जो उसको स्टमक में है एब्डोमेन में है मास वो रीनल सेल कार्सिनोमा है और वो उसके मेटास्टेसिस होके वो लंग में गया है और लंग में से आपने बायोप्सी की तो आपको रीनल सेल कार्सिनोमा लंग के अंदर मिल रहा है क्योंकि वो मेटास्टेटिक है इज इट द सिनेरियो व्हिच इज फिटिंग हियर और ट्यूमर रेयरली गिव राइज टू बोन मैट्स इज इट राइट और इट इज अ स्क्वामस सेल कार्सिनोमा मोस्टली ऑफ लंग ओरिजिन इज इट द इमेज ऑफ स्क्वामस सेल कार्सिनोमा So you have to decide, is it an image of TB, is it an image of squamous cell carcinoma, or is it an image of RCC clear cell type? There are four types of RCC, na? Clear cell, papillary, chromophobe, collecting duct. So this is clear cell, wala hai, jo ki most common. Hota hai. In tino mein se ye image hai kiska. You have to decide that. So yes, Diksha, again Diksha is right. Anyone else want to try? Yes, anyone else? So kya hai? So teen option padke, there are three options. Is it an image of tuberculosis? No, it is not an image of tuberculosis. Because it doesn't contain granuloma. I can't see even a single granuloma. It is not a case of squamous cell carcinoma also. Because I can't find keratin pulse or keratinization, which is the hallmark of squamous cell carcinoma. I can't see that. Yes, it can be renal cell carcinoma clear type. So you will say, ma'am, renal cell carcinoma lung ke andar kyun mil raha hai? Renal cell carcinoma to kidney mein milna chahiye na? Yes, it is metastatic renal cell carcinoma, not primary. Primary kidney ke andar hai. Wo metastatic hoke distant mets karke lung mein aaya hai. तो आप लंग की बायोप्सी करोगे तो किडनी का ट्यूमर मिलेगा सो इट इज रीनल सेल कार्सिनोमा क्लियर टाइप व्हिच इज प्रेजेंट इनसाइड द लंग सो इट इज फिटिंग विद द हिस्ट्री आल्सो ना शी इज हैविंग अ एब्डोमिनल मास आल्सो तो ये भी उससे प्रूव हो गया एब्डोमिनल मास उसको रीनल ट्यूमर होगा शी इज हैविंग हिमैच्यूरिया आल्सो यो वो भी इससे प्रूव हो गया और शी इज हैविंग मल्टीपल लंग मासेस क्योंकि अगर स्क्वैमस सेल कार्सिनोमा होगा तो वो तो सिंगल होगा ना अगर ये लंग्स है लेडी के इफ शी इज हैविंग स्क्वैमस सेल कार्सिनोमा दैट विल बी अ सिंगल लिजन दैट इज नॉट मल्टीपल तो यहाँ पे मल्टीपल लिजन है तो मल्टीपल मेट्स हो सकते हैं मल्टीपल टीबी भी हो सकता है लेकिन टीबी में ग्रेनुलोमा होगा तो यहाँ पे ग्रेनुलोमा नहीं दिख रहा है तो यू हैव टू रूल आउट अदर ऑप्शंस आल्सो सो यू कैन सी द ट्यूमर सेल्स आर अरेंज्ड इन नेस्ट These are small, small nests, all or they are arranged in sheets. And if you zoom it out, you will see the tumor cells have a clear cytoplasm. Why the cytoplasm is clear? Because of excessive glycogen in the cytoplasm. Because of excessive glycogen in the cytoplasm is clear here. The cytoplasm is clear here. So it is a typical presentation here. The correct answer here is B. So I would like to tell you something here about renal cell carcinoma. As I have told you, there are four types: clear cell, papillary, chromophobe, also known as oncocytic, and collecting duct. So is bar to question clear cell pe maine diya. Ye image diya aur question clear cell pe tha. Maybe agli bar question papillary pe aa jaye, maybe chromophobe pe aa jaye, maybe collecting duct pe aa jaye. So you should know image of all of them. You should know image. So bahut briefly in 5 minutes I will complete it. I will tell you the images of these. So there are four types. Gross sabka same hai. Grossly it usually happens on one of the pole. So it is polar tumor. It occurs either on upper pole or lower pole. Upper pole is more commonly involved. Can you see? This is the kidney and the tumor is present on the pole. So tumor is present on the pole of the kidney, usually upper pole. Tumor is large, usually yellow color, circumscribed. So these are the gross findings you can see. You can see here also a tumor is shown. Here also you can see the tumor is on the upper pole. This is the tumor, yellowish, golden yellowish tumor on the upper pole of the kidney. So it is polar tumor. The four types are in front of you: clear cell, papillary, chromophobe also known as oncocytic, and collecting duct. So among these, clear cell is most common type. Now you have to learn mutation in each of them. Clear cell is due to chromosome 3 number ka deletion of chromosome 3, deletion of short arm of chromosome 3. There is a gene on it known as VHL, von Hippel-Lanadu gene. So VHL gene, you have to learn all these, because in this era of molecular therapy, you should be aware of the name of these genes and mutations. So that is the gene or mutation in clear cell, which is the most common type. Papillary is of two types, sporadic and familial. So sporadic ho ya familial ho, there is not deletion, there is trisomy. Deletion ka ulta hai trisomy. Usually it is diploid na. Diploid se monoploid ho raha hai, that is deletion ho raha hai. और डिप्लॉइड से ट्रिप्लॉइड हो रहा है, ट्राइजोमी हो रही है यहाँ. तो ट्राइजोमी कौन कौन से क्रोमोसोम की? क्रोमोसोम 7, 16, 17. फैमिलियल है तो सिर्फ 7, स्पोरेडिक है तो 7, 16, 17. अलोंग विद देयर इज ट्रांसलोकेशन ऑफ एक्स एंड 1. ट्रांसलोकेशन जैसे 922 ट्रांसलोकेशन होता है सीएमएल में, सेम ट्रांसलोकेशन एक्स और 1, क्रोमोसोम नंबर एक्स और 1 में होगा. यस, एक्स इज प्रेजेंट इन मेल्स ऑल्सो, फीमेल्स ऑल्सो, डबल एक्स इन फीमेल्स एंड एक्स वाई इन मेल्स. तो एक्स दोनों में ही होगा, तो एक्स और 1 के बीच में ट्रांसलोकेशन हो रहा है. So that is seen in papillary. On chromophobe, learn hypoploidy. It is hypo, not trisomy. It is diploidy se hypoploidy ho rahi hai. Multiple chromosomes ki. Don't learn the number. Just see 1, 2, 6, 10, 13, 17, 21, Y. Yahan pe chromosome Y hai. Yahan pe chromosome X tha. So in sab ki hypoploidy ho rahi hai. Collecting duct ka it is not. So you have to learn it. You have to learn it. The genetic is clear to you. So clear cell ka diagram already maine discuss kar liya hai. Clear cell is the most common, it arises from PCT. And you can see the diagram, you can see the tumor. Yahi diagram, ye Robbins ka diagram hai aur yahi us image mein tha. So you can see tumor cells are arranged in nest or sheet. All the tumor cells are clear. Try to see the cytoplasm. Now I will mark a cell. This is a tumor cell. This is a nucleus inside it. And you can see a clear cytoplasm around all cell. Cytoplasm is clear because of excessive glycogen in the cytoplasm. Done. So that is the thing. And VHL gene maine bata diya. Second is papillary. It is the second most common type. It arises from DCT. Here typically you will see papillary ka matlab hota hai finger-like projection. So can you see a finger-like projection? So tumor cells are not arranged in sheets. They are not arranged in nest. They are arranged in finger-like projections. And can you see the tumor cells lining these finger-like projections? These are cuboidal, small cuboidal round cells. These are not clear cells. And hallmark here is sarcoma body. You know what is sarcoma body? It is a calcium crystal present. So sarcoma bodies are present here. So that is the thing. And the third one is chromophobe. Here the typical arrangement, all the tumor cells, see any tumor cell, the typical, it is having a perinuclear halo. What do you mean by perinuclear halo? This is a tumor cell. This is the nucleus of the tumor cell. And this is the cytoplasm. I will draw cytoplasm with red color. So this is the cytoplasm. So you can see just around the nucleus, there is a clear space. So that clear space around the nucleus is known as peri, around the nucleus, nuclear halo, a perinuclear halo. So see, all tumor cells have this perinuclear halo. So that is typical finding here in chromophobe. This is the clue. So you have to take the clues, and collecting duct is not important, it is least important. So this is the origin of each of them. So clinical features you already know. Hamari patient ko, she was having hematuria, she was having back pain on the left side and she was having a palpable abdominal mass. This is the triad. Pura ka pura triad fit ho raha hai humare scenario mein. So that is the thing. That is the thing. The survival is 70%, 5-year survival. Now see our question again. This is the question. Try to solve it now. So age dekho 54 year hai. Isko teen problem hai. Left side back pain. और एब्डोमिनल पेन और पेल्विक पेन और लंबर पेन यू कैन से बैक में है लेफ्ट साइड पे हिमैच्यूरिया एंड अ पाल्पेबल मास सो टिपिकल ट्रायड ऑफ आरसीसी शी इज हैविंग टिपिकल ट्रायड और अपार्ट फ्रॉम ये तीन चीजें उसको लंग में मासेस हैं तो ये जो लंग में मास है वो आरसीसी का मेट्स है तो पहले ये ट्रायड देख के डायग्नोसिस बनाओ आरसीसी है इमेज देख के डायग्नोसिस बनाओ कौन सा आरसीसी है So out of the 4 RCC, it is clear cell ka image hai. So it is clear cell RCC, which is going to the lung. Biopsy is done from the lung. So this is the biopsy of the lung. I hope the scenario is clear to you. So this is the next question in front of you. This is the next question in front of you. So see the image, read the question. Don't rush. Just read the question, see the image, and then tell me what is the answer. Read the option. So what is the age given here? 8-year-old boy. So he's a child, 8-year-old boy. Presented with fever. Fever aate hi, there is some infection. That's why fever is there. So presented with fever and sore throat. Sore throat hai. So maybe some bacterial infection. So sore throat, fever, followed by dark urine. So pehle sore throat hua. Uske baad dark urine means hematuria and edema. So hematuria and edema is indicating nephritic or nephrotic. Nephritic hai ki nephrotic hai? I have told you very clearly hematuria. And periorbital edema, edema to dono mein hoga. Hematuria is typically present in nephritic syndrome. So sore throat followed by nephritic syndrome. What is the cause? Ban gaya hoga diagnosis to. Renal biopsy ka diagram is shown here. And there is subepithelial deposits also. This is one of the clue. So you can see the renal biopsy. To kya dikh raha hai? Biopsy mein kya dikh raha hai aap logon ko? What you can see the biopsy? Anyone from the audience want to tell? What is the correct answer? Is it diabetic glomerulosclerosis? Is it membranous glomerulonephritis? MPN? MGN, is it minimal change disease? MCD, bachcha hai to ho sakta hai minimal change disease bachcho mein hoti hai. Or is it APGN? Is it APGN, acute proliferative glomerulonephritis? Iska dusra naam hai post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis. PSGN aur APGN ek hi baat hota hai. Anyone from the audience, yes, want to try? Yes? Anyone from the audience want to try? Say yes or no? Okay, I will tell you the answer. What you can see here in the image, what is the clue given in the image? You can see a glomerulus here. You can see a glomerulus here. This is the glomerulus. This is the glomerulus. Inside the glomerulus, what you can see? You can see hypercellularity. Let me see. Yeah, this is the image. So this is the clear image. You can see the glomerulus here. Yes, you people are right. So Himanshu Garg is right. Amit Gupta is right. So you people are saying D is the correct answer. That is APGN. Why Himanshu? Why Amit? What clues you get from the question or from the image or compiling the both, you are saying the answer. Now, clues are given both. Question mein clinical history se bhi mujhe clues mil rahe. Patient ko fever hai aur sore throat hai. Toh maybe streptococcal, beta streptococcal infection hua hoga. Sore throat mein. Aur wahan se wo gaya blood mein. Beta streptococcus. Blood se wo gaya kidney mein. Kidney mein jaake deposit hua. Peeche peeche antibody gayi. So, antigen-antibody reaction hua. Uski wajah se glomerulonephritis hua hai. So that is the reason. So correct answer here is D. And in the image, what you can see a glomerulus here. Inside the glomerulus, you can see multiple neutrophils. If you zoom it out more, you will see these all cells are inflammatory neutrophil cells. So neutrophils inside a glomerulus, the only diagnosis is PSGN. It is hypercellular post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis or acute proliferative glomerulonephritis. One and the same thing. Post-streptococcal because it occurs after streptococcus infection. And acute proliferative because it is always sudden. Within few days it occurs. And proliferative because it is hypercellular. The glomerulus is hypercellular. Cellularity is due to inflammatory cell. Usually neutrophils. So if you find glomerulus to be hypercellular after any fever or sore throat episode. So it has to be APGN. So yes, Himanshu, you are right. Diksha, history plus infection. Correct, Diksha. Very correct. So let me explain you APGN here, APGN. And why it is not minimal change? Himanshu, Diksha, Amit, why it is not minimal change? Because his child, na, the age is going with the minimal change. Age is going. Two things are not going with the minimal change. What those two things are? I'm asking to you, those who are listening me, Diksha, Himanshu, Amit, or anyone else who can listen me. Why it is not minimal change MCD? Why? You should rule out other options also, na? The first thing, it is not MCD, minimal change disease, because there is dark urine. There is hematuria in the urine. That is, it is nephritic syndrome. And in MCD, there is nephrotic syndrome. MCD mein kabhi bhi blood nahi aayega urine mein. There is no hematuria. So that is going against it. Number one, this thing is going against. Dusra, the diagram. In MCD, what is the diagram? In MCD, yes, nephrotic, you are right, Amit. MCD mein, what is the diagram? Himanshu, age to uske saath ja raha hai na. Himanshu is saying age. So age to match kar raha hai. MCD bachcho mein hi hota hai. What is the diagram of MCD? Histological diagram in MCD. Minimal change disease mein diagram kya hoga? Why it is known as minimal change disease? Do you know the word minimal? Minimal change ka matlab kya hota hai? Diagram mein kuch nahi milega. It is absolutely normal glomerulus. So yahan pe hypercellular ki jagah agar ekdam normal glomerulus hota aur 8 saal ka hi bachcha hota aur dark urine nahi hota to mera answer MCD hota. So you should be able to answer all type of glomerulonephritis. Minimal change yani change nahi hoga glomerulus mein. On light microscopy, electron microscopy pe zarur milega. So it is not MCD. Aur membranous to bado mein hi hoga. Glomerulonephritis maine already samjha diya, the two type, diffuse and nodular. So it is not the scenario, neither the diffuse nor the glomerular, not the nodular, because hyaline deposition nahi hai. Un dono mein hyaline deposition hoga, diffuse wale mein diffusely aur nodular wale mein in the form of the nodules, but there should be a hyaline deposition. Yahan pe I can't see hyaline deposition. In this image I can see only one thing, that is hypercellularity because of inflammatory cells. So it is a typical presentation of APGN. APGN or PSGN is one and the same thing. Students have confusion. Just clear this confusion. Dono ek hi baat hai, APGN or PSGN. Hota kya hai? Imagine karo there is a child. Wo child ko hua group A beta streptococcus se infection, pharyngitis or tonsillitis. So imagine he is a child. Ye child hai. This is the child. These are the tonsils of the child. Child is having group A beta streptococcus infection. The red color, the bacteria is there. So the bacteria is going to the blood. It is causing tonsillitis. After that, it is going to the blood. Via blood, it is going to the kidneys. These are the kidneys. So this bacteria is reaching the kidney. So this is the bacteria. It is reaching the kidney. It is going inside the kidney. Inside the kidney, there is a filtration membrane. Let me draw a filtration membrane for you separately. Let me draw. So in the filtration membrane, there is a basement membrane in the center. There is endothelium on one side and there is podocytes or epithelium on the other side. So where this bacteria is deposited, bacteria is going in the kidney. After going in the kidney, this is the bacteria, it is deposited. The bacteria is deposited over podocytes. This is the podocytes on the epithelium, the podocytes, visceral epithelium, uspe bacteria deposit ho gaya. Now and body will form antibody against it. Of course, har cheez ke against antibody banti hai. So antibodies are formed against it. So antibody bhi piche piche aayegi. So that antibody will form complex with the antigen. And because of this antigen-antibody complex formation, patient will have glomerulonephritis and neutrophils aake waha inflammation karenge. So glomerulus is looking hypercellular. So that is the whole story. So the bacteria is going and depositing over the podocytes there. Via blood it is going, causing pharyngitis. Via blood going to the kidney, in the kidney deposited over podocytes. So this is known as planted antigen. So antibodies are formed against it, antigen-antibody complexes are formed, and that will be seen in the form of deposits, the antigen-antibody complexes. These are sub-epithelial deposits. So that is the thing. Here grossly, there is a typical gross. Now, agla question is pe aayega. Ye kidney deke pooch lenge kiski kidney hai. What is the disease underlying this kidney, for this kidney? So in the kidney, you can typically see? You can see multiple reddish spots on the kidney. ऐसा लग रहा है कि किडनी को फ्लिया ने काट लिया. सो इट इज नोन एज फ्लिया बिटन. फ्लिया इज अ मस्कीटो, इट इज अ इंसेक्ट लाइक. फ्लिया बिटन किडनी, तो फ्लिया ने मल्टीपल जगह किडनी को काट लिया. इट इज नोन एज फ्लिया बिटन किडनी. फ्लिया बिटन किडनी और भी डिजीजेस में होती है अपार्ट फ्रॉम इट. सो फ्लिया बिटन किडनी इज टिपिकली सीन इन PSGN हियर. सो फ्लिया बिटन पे भी क्वेश्चन आ सकता है, इमेज बेस्ड क्वेश्चन. एंड इन द माइक्रोस्कोपी यू कैन सी अ ग्लोमेरुलस विच इज हाइपर सेलुलर. And you can see multiple neutrophils inside it because of antigen-antibody reaction. These are the neutrophils. So that is a typical microscopy. Compare it with normal. The first on the left-hand side, the image is normal. On the right-hand side, it is PSGN. Compare the two glomerulus. See glomerulus here and see glomerulus here. Compare it. The second one is hypercellular. And cellularity is increased because of inflammatory cells, lymphocyte and neutrophils, especially neutrophils, because it is acute. Done. Should I proceed? On electron microscopy, you will find subepithelial deposits. The deposits, can you see? These are the subepithelial deposits here. This one, diagram from Robbins. So these are the subepithelial big deposits. It is known as lumpy deposits. Lumpy, bumpy, dumpy, lumpy, bumpy, because of the size. These are big deposits and these are subepithelial. Done. And this is the immunofluorescence showing granular deposits made up of IgG. So light microscopy pe hypercellularity, electron microscopy pe subepithelial lumpy, bumpy, dumpy deposits, or immunofluorescence pe granular deposits. Give me a thumbs up. That was all about APGN and it presents with nephritic syndrome. Hamare patient ko hematuria hai na. So it is fitting there. So nephritic mein hematuria hoga. Give me a thumbs up. I'm sorry. Just a second. I'm really sorry. So give me a thumbs up. Everyone. Done? Okay. So this is the next question in front of you. Should I launch the next question? Are you people interested? Okay. So this is the next question in front of you. Easy one. I guess you will be able to solve it. See the image. Should I show you the image separately? Let's see. Okay. Image hai nahi mere paas separately. Isi mein dekho. The glomerulonephritis histologically presents by numerous what? Can you see? One of the glomerulonephritis is shown in this image. In this glomerulonephritis, what you can see? Numerous kya dikh rahe hai? Is image mein dekho. You can see two glomerulus here. Us glomerulus mein kya pathology dikh rahi hai? Can you see numerous intramembranous dense deposit? Yes or no? Can you see numerous atrophic PCT? Yes or no? These all are PCTs. These are the tubules. These are numerous atrophic tubules. Ye pathology hai kya? Can you see numerous hyalinized small arterioles in this image? Find out. Or can you see epithelial cell crescents? Numerous crescents. Kya dikh raha hai is image mein? What you can see? What is the pathology given in this image? You can see two glomerulus, multiple tubules, few blood vessels. It is given to you. So typical image of a disease. First, identify the disease. Who will give me the diagnosis of this disease? Give me the diagnosis. The answer is in front of you. What is the diagnosis typically shown here? Yes. Anyone? Yes. Should I mark it for you? Just a second. Give me a second. Should I mark it for you? You can see something here in this glomerulus. Here. And you can see something here. I will mark in this also. See, something here. Here to here. I'm highlighting it. Now say, what pathology is this? See the shape of this yellow color. Maybe you can identify the pathology by looking at the shape of this yellow color. The yellow color is showing the pathology. So Amit is saying C, Diksha is saying B. So Amit, I guess you are wrong, and Diksha, yes, you are right. So D is the correct answer. Can you see yellow color? The shape of this yellow color is crescent. Can you see this crescent? Can you see? Let me use an eraser now and see this crescent. I'm erasing there also. Now see this crescent. You will be able to see the crescent now. Ab maine highlight kiya to ab dekho zoom karke image ko. You will be able to find out the crescent. Just a second. Give me a second. I can't see your chat. Okay. So you can see the crescent. Okay. Just a second. Yeah. So it is RPGN. The diagnosis is RPGN. You are right. The diagnosis is RPGN. In RPGN, we find multiple crescents. So the correct answer here is D. I can't find any intramembranous dense deposit here. The membranes are absolutely clear. I can't find atrophic PCT. The PCTs are absolutely normal here. And I can't find hyalinized small arterioles. Arterioles us mein dikhi nahi rahe. But I can find crescents. So it is a typical diagram of RPGN. In RPGN, we find crescents. That is the pathogmatic feature of RPGN. So this is a typical crescent you can see, which is made up of epithelial cells. Parietal epithelial cells. All these are parietal epithelial cells with cell debris it is made up of. So this is a glomerulus. Let me mark the glomerulus. This is the glomerulus. In the glomerulus, a crescent. Crescent yani adha chandrama, sickle shape. So can you see this sickle shape? So this sickle shape is there. It is also hypercellular. Thode bahut neutrophils yahan bhi hain APGN jitne. Lekin apart from hypercellularity, there is crescent also. So that is the thing here. Done. So crescents are there. The diagnosis is RPGN. So this is the last image in front of you. Please see the image and tell me what is the correct answer. Please read the last question. A 10-year-old boy. Take the clues from the question. A 10-year-old boy is there with edema. Patient is having edema. So patient is a child. Patient is having edema and decreased urinary output. So oliguria. Edema is there. Oliguria is there. Serum albumin is 2.5. That is hypoalbuminemia. What is the normal range of serum albumin? Creatinine abnormal. Urine protein is 3+. एंड नो आरबीसी, हिमैक्यूरिया नहीं है. सो फर्स्ट टेल मी नेफ्राइटिक है कि नेफ्रोटिक है. हिमैक्यूरिया नहीं है, सीवियर प्रोटीन्यूरिया है, और प्रोटीन्यूरिया की वजह से हाइपोएल्बुमिनेमिया है. सो वेदर इट इज नेफ्राइटिक और नेफ्रोटिक, यस यू आर राइट. सो इट इज अ नेफ्रोटिक. सो फर्स्ट यू हैव टू डिसाइड इन रीनल वेदर इट इज नेफ्राइटिक और नेफ्रोटिक. सो पहले ही मेरे लेक्चर में मैंने डिफरेंस बताया. सो इट इज नेफ्रोटिक एंड इट इज अ चाइल्ड. नाउ यू टेल मी व्हाट इज द मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज ऑफ नेफ्रोटिक सिंड्रोम इन अ चाइल्ड. और द चाइल्ड है नेफ्रोटिक सिंड्रोम है, एक ही आंसर हो सकता है, एक ही आंसर हो सकता है. हु विल टेल मी द आंसर. मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज ऑफ नेफ्रोटिक सिंड्रोम इन अ चाइल्ड, वी विल लुक एट द इमेज ऑल्सो, उससे कोरिलेट करेंगे ना इमेज से. तो मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज ऑफ नेफ्रोटिक सिंड्रोम इन चाइल्ड इज एमसीडी, मिनिमल चेंज डिजीज. यस यू आर राइट, मिनिमल चेंज डिजीज. मिनिमल चेंज डिजीज के इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोपी पे क्या दिखता है? दिस इज नॉट लाइट माइक्रोस्कोपी, दिस इज इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोपी. व्हाट थिंग यू आर सीइंग हियर, यू कैन सी दिस इज द बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन हियर. ऑन वन साइड ऑफ द बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन, दिस इज बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन. ऑन वन साइड यू कैन फाइंड द एंडोथेलियल सेल. So this is the endothelial cell. This is the, on other side, you find podocytes. You find podocytes. So this is a podocyte here. This is a podocyte. The podocytes are relatively flattened. Normally, wo aise bade bade aise. Podocytes are known as podocytes. Podocyte ko podocyte kyun kehte hain? Because it is the shape of a foot, human foot. Pair ke panje jaisa hota hai. Isliye podo, podo means foot. It is means foot, podocyte. But now podocytes aise ho gaye. So instead of this, it is looking like this. So flattening of podocyte is shown in this image. It is a typical image of MCD. Please learn it. So clinical scenario bhi MCD ke saath ja raha hai aur image bhi MCD ke saath ja raha hai. So it is MCD, minimal change disease. So correct answer here is B. Minimal is known as minimal kyunki light microscopy normal hogi, lekin electron microscopy pe you will find flattening of the podocytes. It is most common cause of nephrotic syndrome but not in adults. 80% it occurs in children only. So यूजुअली 16 ईयर्स ऑफ एज, तो हमारा चाइल्ड क्वेश्चन में 10 ईयर्स का है. हमारा चाइल्ड 10 ईयर्स का है. ग्रॉसी इट इज नॉर्मल, लाइट माइक्रोस्कोपी इज नॉर्मल, यू कैन सी ग्लोमेरुलस आर एब्सोल्युटली नॉर्मल, एब्सोल्युटली नॉर्मल. ग्लोमेरुलस इज एब्सोल्युटली नॉर्मल ऑन लाइट माइक्रोस्कोपी, बट ऑन इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोपी यू विल फाइंड फ्लैटनिंग और इफेसमेंट ऑफ द फूड प्रोसेस. कैन यू सी दिस सेल, इट इज फ्लैटन्ड, इट इज फ्लैटन्ड. सो इट इज फ्लैटनिंग. नाउ कंपेयर दिस विद दिस. नॉर्मली देखो कितने बड़े बड़े हैं और अब ये फ्लैट होते जा रहे हैं. दे आर बिकमिंग फ्लैट, they are becoming flat, flattening. So ye image, ye Robbins ka image hai aur ye tha aapke question mein wahan pe. This was the image given in your question. Compare it with normal. Yes, have you got it? So flattening is there and no deposits on immunofluorescence. So light microscopy, no abnormality. Immunofluorescence, no abnormality. Only electron microscopy pe fusion or flattening of the food processes. Give me a thumbs up. And it causes nephrotic syndrome, not nephritic. Prognostic is good. Steroid therapy is given and patient drastically respond through the steroid. So that was all about it. Abhi tak ki images itni hi. Thank you very much. If you like it and if you want more image based question or clinical scenario based question on various systems, so I'm taking it on all other systems also. So I have taken CVS, I have taken renal, lekin complete nahi hua hai. Abhi bahut sare aur baki hai. So agar wo sab tumhe dekhne hai, if you want a lecture on them also, so it is available free of cost, but not on YouTube. It is available where? It is available on Unacademy app. So go to the Play Store, install Unacademy Learners app from the Play Store in your mobile. After that, search my profile link, my name under profile link. My name is Dr. Priyanka Sachdev. See in the background, the spelling, Dr. Priyanka Sachdev. You will find my profile link, follow it. Once you follow my profile link, you will get two things. Number one, you will get all recordings of my past previous lectures free of cost. And second, you will get notifications of my upcoming lectures. And you will require a code. It is free, but you will require a code. The code is Sachdev10. S-A-C-H-D-E-V, Sachdev10 is the code. So use this code, distribute this code to all medicos, your juniors, seniors, your interns in your college, your batchmates, anyone, all medicos all over the globe. So don't hesitate to put this code on your batch groups. And let's everyone enjoy this free knowledge, yes or no? So yeah, then let everyone take the benefit of it. So you can give it to all medicos who are preparing either for NEET PG or FMG or INICT or NEXT. So you can distribute to them and it is free of cost. And there are two options on the app. The one option is free class, one is paid one. The free one is known as special class. Paid one is known as plus or iconic. Paid may be two option. Hai. So free mein jo special classes, hai, there is an option of poll. So I always launch poll and ask the question in the form of polls and you will get lecture notes there. Iske notes bhi wahan tumhe milenge. So just right now aap wahan pe jaake iske notes PDF install kar sakte ho, download kar sakte ho and you can read it from the notes. So these are the advantages of special classes over YouTube classes. Paid की बात करें तो paid में there are two things, plus and iconic. In plus you will get access to live and recorded Unacademy lectures and there are structured courses available there along with live quiz, live test, printed notes, 25,000 more questions containing clinical questions from the India's topmost educators. And in iconic along with Unacademy lectures you will also get access to prep ladder. Prep ladder recorded lectures and my batch is also available on it for the next 2023 in the plus platform. You can take advantage of that also. Apart from my batch, other batches are also available, one for FMG, one for next 2022 and two for NEET PG. Those who are appearing next month on 11th of September in the NEET PG, for them there is 1 month package. It is very cost economic package, only 4,500, and you will get 10% discount on it if you use my code. Again, the code is same, Sachdev Tag. So you can utilize this package in the last days of your preparation. And there is a high yielding clinical question bank available on the app containing more than 25,000 clinical questions. More than 25,000 clinical questions. Two last offers for you. If you take a subscription for 12 months, you will get 2 months extra. If you take a subscription for 4 years, it will cost around 60,000 in plus and 75,000 in iconic. So that is the most cost effective. Cost effective subscription, and these are the other subscriptions available on the platform. For plus, starting from 1 month till 4 years, in iconic starting from 12 months till 4 years, and you can convert your price into monthly installments also, which is very cost economic. 1200 for the plus, 1400 for the iconic. Longer the subscription, cheaper it is. So better to go with longer subscription if you are a first prof, second prof student. Done. Remember, the code is Sachdev 10. Whatever subscription you are planning, this, whatever, 1 month or 4 year, you will get maximum discount if you use my code SACHDEV10. So just apply the code before payment. Done. If you have any doubts, please take the snapshot of your doubt and post it to us on the app. We will answer you. We have a Telegram channel also, that is Let's Crack NEET PG. Please join it for getting the notification. Follow my profile link on the app. See the spelling of my name. Search it under educators. You will find my name, Dr. Priyanka Sachdev, and there is a profile link. Please follow it. Tomorrow I will meet you again in the morning at 11 and at 11 a.m. and 12 a.m. Tomorrow in the morning I am taking GIT ke clinical questions, clinical based questions on 11 and image based question from GIT at 12. So don't dare to miss it, please. I want all of you to be there in the morning lecture on YouTube only. So the lecture will be free of cost. It is available on YouTube only. See you. Bye-bye. Good night. Study hard.